the whole city, series, cigars and citrus sevens, black cement threes, fours, the hairs and bread 11s. No doubt that I'll be wearing some fire at any sighting. With these Doran Becker 5s, you can see me in any lighting. It's exciting, I'll be flexing to the coldest degree.
What's up, everybody? It's Sneakerhead MCHEX. I just picked up these Atmosphere or Bubblegum Jordan 1s, whatever you want to call them, scheduled to release Wednesday, December 22nd. So as usual, we're going to take a close detail look at the shoe from all angles. After that, I'm going to share my opinion on them, and then we'll get into release and reselling predictions and all that stuff. So let's get right to it.
For some reason, you can't really see it that well on camera, but these have like a iridescent thing going on, and looks real fire in person. So I don't know why it's not like picking up on camera.
I took these outside thinking that maybe the sunlight would, you know, help show it, but it still looks the same. You know, can't really see the iridescence on camera for whatever reason, but I promise y'all in person they have a iridescent thing on this pink patent leather. Let's go inside and look at the rest of the shoe. I actually didn't notice that this shoe was navy until I saw him in person. Whole time I thought it was black and pink and white, but you can see right here, this is definitely navy. The toe, it's really dark, but the toe is navy. You know, the tongue. So it's navy and pink, not black and pink. Come with an extra pair of white laces and an extra pair of pink laces. And as black as this swoosh looks right here, I promise y'all, it is navy. Looks a little bit more. Yeah, you can see it right here with the stitching. I don't know if I've ever been so fooled by pictures before. Now I'm about to go look at the pictures because I really feel like I'm damn near colorblind. Oh, and then the other shoe comes with the hang tag. Got the Nike Air on both sides. That is the side. Very good quality on these two. Everything looks real neat and well put together. And we don't always get that in general, but we really don't always get that with ones. You know, I don't really see any glue stains. So they did their thing with these. Here's the back. So the back side of the tongue is actually black. Then you see the rest of the interior is that navy blue. Insoles are also navy and have the pink Nike Air logo. Here are the soles. Now if you look over here towards the bottom of the right shoe, they have this darker pink mark on them. I read somewhere that this is supposed to signify like stepping in gum because, you know, Jordan really liked bubble gum, but I don't know how accurate that is. I mean, I know Jordan liked bubble gum because he used to be chewing it in all the games, but number one, this looks more like bubble gum to me than this. So I'm not 100% sure. I mean, I guess there's plenty of bubblegum in that color, but I just don't, this doesn't really scream I stepped in gum, you know. It could mean that, but it could also mean something else. So let me know what y'all think, but either way, this is the sole. They come in a navy and white ones box. I'm not really sure why they didn't do it navy and pink to match the shoe. I mean, this still matches, but I think the pink would have been cooler. Then on the inside, they have some special paper with Jumpman and Jordan written in script on it. And here's the box label.
Retail for women's size is going to be $170.
Here's a quick all-around view of the shoe. All right, now let's talk about
them. Man, these are crazy. Beautiful shoe, great choice of materials, quality's amazing. Thumbs up for me. Having the rust pinks already, I didn't think that I was going to want these, but I do. The pinks aren't even close to the same shade, and it doesn't hurt to have both because I don't have a lot of different pink shoes anyway. So I will be copping a pair of these for myself on the 22nd. Leave me a comment, let me know what y'all thinking about doing. Are you copping them for yourself, copping them for somebody else? Are you reselling them? Are you completely passing? Let me know. I was kind of wondering why they decided to give these the Atmosphere nickname. When I think of Atmosphere, I don't really think of pink. The bubblegum thing makes sense. You know, Jordan used to chew gum a lot when he played, and this pink, this really light pink, looks like bubblegum. Like I said, I don't know about the thing on the bottom, but this pink for sure looks like some, you know, like bazooka bubblegum. I don't know if that's what Jordan actually chewed, but you know, now that I think about it, you know, back in the 90s when Jordan played, I don't know if they had all these exotic colored gums. You know, I was saying earlier, like, you know, gum be this color, but, like, did they really have, like, the dark pink gum in the 90s? Like, wasn't all gum, like, this color back then? Yeah, no? I don't know. I'm saying it like they just added colors to food, like, in the last couple years. But y'all know what I'm saying. Somebody find me a picture of Jordan chewing some gum that's not this color pink. I highly doubt we could find him chewing, like, some green gum or some blue gum. But like, maybe this, but anyway, enough about the gum. Reselling these should be a nice, easy, if you're looking to maximize your profit on reselling these, I would definitely go after the bigger sizes because those will resell for more than the smaller sizes will. A lot of releases have been like that in general, but when it comes to shoes that come in women's sizes, it's even more definite. I believe a women's 12 is the biggest size for these, so if you're reselling, I would go for that. Even 11 and a half or 11 should be around the same price. But even if you end up getting these in a smaller size, you'll still be able to flip them and make good profit. I feel like they'll resell between like 250 and like 320-ish, depending on size. Should be a good shoe to hold on to as well, but I'm just not 100% sure because, like I said earlier, they do come in women's size. If you don't already know, when it comes to holding on to Jordans that come in women's sizes, it can get a little tricky because they tend to go up slower than most men's shoes do. Not all of them though, because there's some of them that just shoot right up, but I feel like compared to men, a lot of the women's shoes that should go up quicker kind of don't for whatever reason. But it could go either way. You know, you got some shoes like the UNC, the Chicago ones. They're high top pair Jordan 1s, and they've been sitting around the same price for months. They've gone up a little bit, but nothing crazy. Not as much as they should have, and not as much as they would have if they were a men's shoe. But then again, there's some pairs like the Seafoam. The Seafoam 1s also came in women's sizes. And those just came out a few months ago, and they've already gone up. So, I mean, if you're feeling lucky, hold on to them. Because besides the fact that these come in women's sizes, everything else about them screams, hold on to me, I'll be a lot in the future. So, I can see them going either way. Good luck to everybody trying to cop a pair of these to wear, especially if you wear a big size, because not only do I think they probably make a little bit less of those sizes, but also, everybody's going to go after them. People know that those are the sizes to resell, so a lot of those bigger sizes are going to go real quick. If you do end up trying to buy them, make sure you go after your women's size and not your men or kid size. For those of you who don't know, your women's size is whatever your men or kid size is plus 1.5. I wear 9.5 in men's, which means I would be a size 11 in women. You know, if you normally wear like a size 5 boys, a 5 GS or whatever, you would be a 6.5 in women. Thank you all for watching. If this video was helpful or informal in any way, I'd really appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up. Also, if you're interested in more early reviews like this and other sneaker-related content, do us both a favor and subscribe to my channel. Just make sure you tap the little bell icon next to the subscribe button and select all. That way, when I put a new video out, you'll get notified and you won't miss out on anything. Thank you all for watching. Everybody, please stay safe and healthy out there, and I'll see you next time.